What I think of Destiny as a magazine is that it's raised the bar. It has offered women across different boundaries a publication that speaks to all of them, not just to one community of women. In fact, the way that it feels for me is that it's a unifying magazine, and if it's possible for a magazine to achieve this, I think that Destiny will be most successful in getting women to feel that they are more effective and impactful in society. There are not enough women who are in leadership positions. And because there are so few, it gets to be interpreted as that women do not support each other. I know enough women who support each other. I support a lot of women who approach me. So I think rather than buy into that thinking, we should rather see how we can change it. A day in my life starts around 9. I avoid anything that starts before that. And it usually comprises of some meetings that could range from board meetings or meeting young people who want to be mentored. And if it's a Tuesday or a Thursday, then I take my grandchildren for swimming, and it finishes around 4. So I have a fairly easy day. I do not pack my day. I'm at that stage of my life where I have the privilege of deciding exactly what I put into my day. And it's usually things that are either enriching myself or enriching someone else. If I had to spend an hour with anyone in history, it would have to be with Michelle and Barack Obama. I'm just so fascinated by the calling that they've responded to, the vision that they hold for humanity everywhere, the hopes that they represent for how the world can be. I'm completely inspired by both of them. As an author, obviously, my all-time favorite book is the book that I wrote, Defining Moments, but if I had the time and enough wisdom to write something else, it would be about how the leadership of women has not been experienced by the world, how the leadership of women has not been leveraged, and how particularly now, at any other time in history, the leadership of women could really bring the balance that I think has been missing in the world. What works for me is being an entrepreneur. I have some sympathy for women who are in a corporate environment because they're really constrained by the demands of corporate environments. But as a fundamental rule, I think that as a woman, you actually need to prioritize. If your children are important, then that's what you have to prioritize. If your career is important, then that's what you have to prioritize. I think trying to split yourself between these opposing interests sometimes doesn't work. My greatest strength is my presence. I believe that my presence is what influences people. It's what shifts consciousness. Just being available to the moment and what it offers, and not thinking about what happened a minute ago or thinking about what might happen 5 minutes from this moment, but just really being in this moment, which is a gift. And that's why it's called the present, because it is a gift. The presence is a gift to our lives. That's where we get our wisdom. That's where we get insights to guide us about what the universe wants us to achieve.